there are really endless use cases for AI if you have the data set. One of the questions we often get is how big is this data? Like, do I need like huge storage to hang on to all this? And the answer is no, because you know, at the source, as the data is coming in, as I mentioned, we're filtering out a lot of the noise. We're just keeping the actionable data that's really suited for AI and ML. So that means our data set, like the actual size of it, is relatively small. We're talking on the order of maybe a couple megabytes per day per cell. So if you do that math, I mean, I can do a network with 20 million customers for a year on maybe 10 terabytes, which is nothing, relatively, right? So if you're trying to sell huge storage, sorry, we're not going to help there. But what it also means is when you ask our data set a question, it's going to come back with an answer in a realistic time frame, right? And that's also important. So one of the struggles that the industry has had is, hey, we've got data, even if it isn't as, quite the way we capture it, to capture granular data, to aggregate it all together, to put it on the storage, it's so big and cumbersome that when they want to ask it a question or run a model, like they hit go and they'll come back, 2 days later and look for the answer and hope that they ask the right question, right? I mean, that's kind of how it's been. You know, with this data set, because it's curated for this type of application, the answers come back, in seconds or minutes. It's very, very fast. So we can do trend analysis, predictive analysis. There's a lot of customer care applications around this. So I'll give you a couple examples of what the data looks like. As it comes into our data lake, we can see, for any given network, this is just as an example, what sites are operating in the, fast, which ones have high latency. This is a network map people are used to, but we'll take it a level deeper, right? So one of the questions that we get is, well, what about, I've got my drive testing, companies, it's Umlaut, it's Root Metrics, it's these different companies that go around, they score our network. Can I get a view into what's going on there, right? So I can go into my, what we call our AI drive test application, right? And this will tell me for a given network, how is their network performing based on the performance metrics that those drive testers are using. So as an example, for this network, the company that they hired to do drive testing, they will measure like how often are consumer applications receiving at least 2 megabits per second. Right? How often is their latency below 100 milliseconds or 50 milliseconds? Like those are the criteria that they set. These aren't ours, these are theirs. And so we say, okay, let's take that information. Because we see every data session, we can report out on every single cell how they're performing against those metrics. That helps them when they're planning their drive testing. It helps them understand where they should focus their efforts, what would make sense. And then we can even dive into, specific cells. Like I picked one out a little bit earlier. So this is, Fox Chapel Lane. Right? So within this cell, we can see what the traffic looks like, what their latency distribution, throughput distribution. We can look at what their consumer experience score is. So consumer experience scoring is a metric that we've at Opanga have put together based on the type of traffic, whether it's gaming or short form video. You have different metrics that are useful, whether it's latency or burst throughput or jitter or delivery cadence. So we create this consumer experience score on a session by session basis and report out to the operator. This is what it actually looks like for your customer. From a customer care standpoint, they're interested in like, hey, here's a customer that seems to be using a lot of data. Let me dive into that user and see what they're doing, right? So I can go all the way in at a per user level and see what's this person's score, what's their latency, what kinds of traffic are they doing, like what are they operating on, all private. So we hash every ID going through. So I don't know who this customer is. If our customers want to know who the subscriber is, there's a mapping they can use. But for us, we keep it all very private, for privacy reasons. But we can see what's happening. We can even see where they're passing through, what cells they've been attaching to, and what they're doing there. And so with this kind of information, you can't, and actually I'm gonna pick a different screen because I've not, hold on. I accidentally said everybody but that user. I meant just show me that user.
I could use an overlay, it's fine.
Okay, so for this particular user I picked out, this is what they're doing. I was like, wow, they're doing a lot of traffic. So I can see what this user, how their experience is. So think customer care. Someone calls in and they're saying, I'm having a problem on the network. You know, customer care can immediately pull up and say, what's been this user's experience over the past week? You know, where, you know, do I see compared to my network or compared to their neighbors, how are they performing? Is there something I need to do? Right, aside from is there an outage or whatever, like what are they doing? What cells are they passing through, right? We can see like how it's progressing. So they have a much better understanding of what's going on with this customer. Is there something that I need to do? There are proactive customer care use cases that that you know people talk about, like if I can profile my network generally for a region or within a particular area of the market, can I identify the low performers that are my gold plan users? Who are the people that are most likely to churn? You know, this information lets us capture all that. So it all comes on the back of the data capture that we're doing and the accessibility of it. And then one of the cool things we're doing, I'll give you kind of a sneak peek, but one of the things we've done is we said, hey, we've got this great data set, let's make it even more accessible. And so we've just now are developing a front end, you know, putting a ChatGPT front end on top of the data set. So now we can ask it questions. So here I was asking this questions before we started talking here, and I said, you know, show me the latency distribution across the network. And so it showed me that, and I said, show me the cell that has the most latency, and it gave me that. And I said, okay, and that was cell 0xF9 whatever, like that cell. And I said, okay, show me the hourly latency and sample counts for that cell during the day. And so, and it returns back this, in a conversational way, information. So you can imagine, depending on whether you're marketing, customer care, network ops, you may have different questions, and this makes it a much easier way to ask, get information back, and get recommendations from the system off of that data set. So that's really what we're about, is like really opening up the capability of you know, the operators to do this kind of analysis, do closed loop stuff, and then, I mean, the sky's the limit, not to use cliches, but if you have the right data, you can do the AI that everybody at this conference is talking about right now. Without that data, you know, you're gonna struggle. For more information, you can go to opanga.com. We've got offices in Seattle and Austin, Texas, Mexico City and London. And we have a great partnership with Dell and others. But come to opanga.com, reach out to us. We have a contact us form, and we'd love to talk to you about it.